Hey guys, it's Monday the 3rd of October. I've just dropped my car off here at Subtech in Penrose. They're specialists in Subaru, and we're going to go inside. We're going to talk with Gareth, and we're going to see some of the parts that are going to go into the new engine rebuild. See you soon. So with Gareth here from Subtech, I've got my car here this morning. So Gareth's just going to show us the pistons and the rods that we've got for the car. So this is the new, this is an aluminium US made forged piston. And that was, what brand was that, Gareth?
That's JE.
JE? Yep, JE pistons and Eagle connecting rods. So Gareth's got a regular piston there.
So I just compare, this is actually out of a version 11. So it's a bit later model than your car, but this is a semi-forged piston, so it's got a forged top on it, but a cast bottom.
Oh, yeah.
You can see all the casting marks in here. You can see where it has been machined and where it hasn't been machined. Just a little bit different style. Still a good piston, but not quite as strong as these forged pistons. You can see also much more strength through where the gudgeon pin goes. A lot of force going through there. And just the slightly different style of piston.
So I was hearing there's a huge amount of G's that go through, you know, like I read 8,500 G's on the piston.
When you start putting boost
through
an engine, obviously a lot more load going on the piston. So,
yeah.
So that's why they need to be a lot stronger. You see extra ribbing through here.
Oh, yes.
To help support the gudgeon pin. A lot of pressure going through there.
All right. And so you get four cylinder heads and four pistons in there.
Yeah, four pistons in this box. So it's a nice set. You've got rings in there. You've got your gudgeon pins, obviously. Stickers.
Oh, yes, yeah.
And there's the C-clips that slot into the side of it.
Gotcha. And they're a bit tricky to remove, aren't they, those C-clips?
Oh, yeah. A pair of C-clip pliers,
yeah.
Okay, so then we've got our forged rods, again stickers and all that sort of thing. So this is a forged rod. If you break it back, again if we're comparing it with a standard rod,
so a reasonable weight to that. What would these be made of, Gareth? Are they steel or aluminium?
They're a forged steel.
Yep.
So if we compare it to a standard factory rod, we can immediately see how much stronger it is through the neck of it.
Yes.
But also we can see that in places it's a lot thinner as well, and that's just higher quality.
Right.
Steel.
Better materials.
Yeah, better materials. We've got ARP rod bolts in here, so they're much stronger rod bolt compared with the factory ones.
Okay, brilliant.
You can also see extra strengthening through there compared with the side of that one. So that's
right,
a forged rod.
Yeah.
You can see again the finish.
Yeah, the finish on this is much smoother, isn't it? Yeah.
Cast rod.
Brilliant. And injectors, we're looking at putting some bigger injectors in, aren't we? Fuel injectors.
Well, I think the goal at the moment is to actually put the engine together.
Yeah, okay.
Because all those sorts of things can be added on afterwards.
Okay.
So,
yeah, sure.
So I think what we'll do for now, because we'll get the engine back together, it up and running.
Yep.
So we've got running right.
Yes. Yeah.
And then we'll make some moves on how to get it going a bit better.
When the engine's together, is it at that point there that we get a dyno tune, or do we wait till a bit later for a dyno tune?
I think we need to discuss what you want to do from there.
Okay.
Dyno tune is sort of the end result of it. That's where you get your maximum tweak out of the engine computer.
Okay.
And that'll give you more fuel delivery, more boost, more ignition, all that sort of thing.
Oh yeah. And when we rebuild the motor, do we replace the gaskets and
everything
and the belts and
everything from bottom end?
Yep.
Right up to the top, everything will be replaced. All the seals.
Yeah.
So it should be as good as a new motor.
Right. Right. Yeah. Perfect. All right. Thanks, Gareth. Thanks for your time.
No problem.
That's awesome. Thanks, guys, for watching.